Let's take a look at one more example. Now, as I mentioned before, often it's helpful to look at these rational functions in factored form. So I will go ahead and factor the denominator here. Now notice there's a common factor of x, and then we would have a remaining quadratic, which would factor as well. I'll put this in parentheses. Now the reason it's helpful to factor is, remember from our previous studies, the zeros of these common factors, in this case x minus 2, do not give us a vertical asymptote, they give us a hole. So right away I'm going to make a note over here, we have a hole at x equals 2. So essentially our function will look like the function f of x is equal to the simplified version, 1 over x times x minus 3, with this hole. So I'm going to go ahead and use the simplified function to find the horizontal and vertical asymptotes. Let's find our horizontal asymptote, if there is one, by taking the limit of the function as x approaches infinity or negative infinity. Now I notice right away that the degree of the denominator, the degree of the denominator is degree 2, the degree of the numerator is 0. This limit is equal to 0. Therefore, there's a horizontal asymptote at y equals 0. Let's sketch that. Next, let's take a look at our vertical asymptotes. Now let's go ahead and use the algebraic method, and then we'll verify the limits that are required from the graph on the graphing calculator. Again, looking at this function here, x equals 0 and x equals 3 are zeros of the denominator. Therefore, we have vertical asymptotes at those values. Let's sketch those. Here's x equals 0. Here's x equals 3. Now remember, to use limits to verify these, we need to find some limits. Let's find the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive side or the right side of the function. Now remember, this has to be either positive or negative infinity. And let's also verify the other vertical asymptote by finding the limit as x approaches 3 from the, let's go from the left side this time. Now to find these limits, we are just going to go ahead and look at the graph on the graphing calculator. So let's go ahead and get our calculators out again. Go to y equals, and let's type in our original function. Well, we can either type in the original, or we can type in the simplified function, as long as we remember the whole. I'm going to go ahead and just type in the simplified function. Look at the graph. Now, as we anticipated, there are three pieces to this function because there are two vertical asymptotes. Now, let's take a look at these limits that we wrote out here, these one-sided limits. As x approaches 0 from the right, or the positive side, you can see that the graph is going down. That's going to give us negative infinity here. Let's take a look at that graph again. Let's approach 3 from the left. And if I approach positive 3 from the left side, again, it will also give us a limit of negative infinity, verifying we do have our vertical asymptotes. Now, to make a complete graph, we do need to go back to the calculator and find some additional points. Again, by hitting second graph, we can scroll up and down here and try to find some points that would be easy to plot and make a nice accurate graph. I've already graphed this function using a different graphing technology, so let's go ahead and take a look at that. Here it is. Again, here we have a vertical asymptote, x equals 0, x equals 3, horizontal asymptote, y equals 0. Now the one thing that we have to add in here, remember there was a hole at x equals 2. it's not showing on this graph, so what we have to do to make an accurate graph is go here to the value where x equals 2, and we should have an open circle to show there is a hole in that graph there. Now, sometimes a function can have a linear asymptote that is neither vertical nor horizontal, which is called a slant or oblique asymptote. For any rational function of the form f of x equal to p of x divided by q of x, a slant asymptote occurs when the degree of p of x, or the numerator, is exactly one more than the degree of the denominator, q of x. A graph can cross a slant asymptote. In general, to find the equation of a slant asymptote, we need to perform long division and then take the limit of that as x approaches positive or negative infinity. Now, there are many strategies to find key components of graphs. I'm not going to go through every single one of these. A lot of these are review, but I will highlight a couple points on each of these. You may want to find intercepts, asymptotes, derivatives, and domain. Critical values of f. Determine whether the function is increasing and or decreasing, as well as relative extrema. Inflection points. Concavity. And the sketch of the graph. You can see the next several videos for additional examples on these topics. Just remember, this section is just a combination of several topics covered in previous sections, so try not to get overwhelmed and just take it one step at a time. Have a great day.